What is going on, everyone? Welcome to Road to Platinum for Tearaway Unfolded. This is a free PS Plus game for March 2017, and if you watch the series from start to end, it'll net you a shiny Platinum trophy. At least I think there is a Platinum trophy. Yep, pretty sure there is. So, this game is actually pretty interesting. It actually utilizes a lot of the 6-axis motion from the controller. So if you move it and tilt it around, then you can do interactive stuff with it. And this game is actually pretty cool. I was very hesitant to play this game, but it's actually pretty easy to complete. One of the things that you have to keep in mind is each level, there are collectibles that comes into play. You have to collect some red presents, some blue presents, which are like side missions, some confettis, which there's a tracker for you to see how many there are, and also pictures you have to take throughout, and also some miscellaneous chapter-specific trophies or actions that you can do. Those ones I'm going to leave at the end. But if you watch this from start to end, I'm going to show you chapter 1, 2, 3, 4, so on and so forth, 100% for each level. There is something though, starting from chapter 3 or something, you have to actually go to a different map to progress through the story. And at that point in time, if you're in chapter 3, you don't have all the abilities yet. So you actually can't get 100% until after. So I'll also mention in each of the videos specifically what action you have to complete first before some of the other collectibles will be available to you. So make sure you check the description below, because there's going to be full details there to take you to the trophies or to take you to the specific objective you have to find in the level. So stay tuned for more. I am working on editing chapter 2 and 3. Need to finish and play more of it, do some recording. So stay tuned again. Hope you guys enjoy watching this series. I appreciate it if you'd like and comment below, because this takes a lot of effort editing, recording, playing, and all that. So hope you guys enjoy. We'll see you guys in the next video.
That's it. Now it's time to unite our worlds.
There! A message!
An invitation from our world to yours. At last, now a real story can begin. This story needs a heroine.
Or a hero.
The message must become a messenger. Ah, this one is called Iota. They've got a message just for you. Shine your light on them.
Maybe try that on something else. Oh, look at that.
I think they liked it too.
Ooh, use the... Oh, yes. You're really breathing life into this world.
You've got their eye. I think they will follow your lead now.
Use your light to guide them. Off again. Let's see where they're going. Oh, now this is important. Heed the squirrels.
The truth is written on their tongues.
Creating a way through to the Use world.
Ayuta, that's where you must deliver your message.
Let the You guide you there. Twig! Oh! Oh my!
That wasn't scary. But this story does need some villains.
What's wrong with crows? Crows are terrifying.
Flimsy man! No! We need something new. Something evil from the Use world. Something like these. Look at them all pouring in. That will give this story a nasty twist.
And what are they called exactly?
Scraps! Horrible little things.
Actually, this is a right cauliflower pickle.
It looks like these people need your help.
Oh,
Well played, both. You drove away the scrappy eye boxes. But I suspect they have more tricks under their lids.
All right, this is my story. Right. Now, the stage is set. Our actors are chosen. Your role is to guide Iota and help him deliver his message. Head for the hole in the sky.
Good luck.
It's my story. Good luck.
Alright, once you get control of the character after you defeat the eye boxes, you'll come to this basketball hoop where you can actually throw these squirrels or gophers, whatever you want to call them, into the net. And then you get a check mark when you're done. There's three nets and basically scatter throughout this little area here. After you complete all three, you'll unlock the blue present, which is like a side mission. If you want to track your progress, just press the options button. It'll tell you exactly what you need. And here's the second one where you have to jump and throw it in, but I kind of failed, so you get the point. Also, after when you're done your first blue present objective, you unlock the trophy called Helping Hand, which is the bronze trophy. So shortly after completing this first blue present, in the middle of the platform, or in the middle of the map, there's this present, and that's your first red present. Coming over to this side of the map, there is this ramp looking thing that has lots of jumpy things, and you just have to walk around it, and once you get to the top, there's the second red present. So now the third red present is located over here. You jump up, go through this bridge and through this thing. There's going to be these colorful sort of rainbow looking things, arches, or whatever you want to call it. When you get to the end, this is the third red present. So here we are doing the blue present, the second blue present in the map. So after that little area with the basketball nets, you actually move to a different area. And here you actually talk to these squirrels and they'll tell you, oh, we need to find some apples. So you take an apple over here or somewhere in this area, you can't miss it. You bring it back and you throw it onto that platform and it'll bounce into the, you know, the picnic. And then that will unlock the blue present number two. So after doing that side mission with the blue present, if you come over here, there's a jump that you can go up onto the tree. And I actually missed this present the first time through, so I came back after everything, and I went to get this present. That's why here you'll see it's 6 of 6, but it's actually the 4th present that you unlock. So something to keep in mind, on my first run through, I actually missed a confetti that was right there into that tree. So just make sure you collect everything and you know, keep an eye out on collecting everything. I think that was kind of, you know, out of the picture. It's kind of, you know, hard to see and it might be missable, so make sure you check that as well. So up on this tree, the squirrel will tell you to remove that blue ball. You actually need those blue balls later. But if you go through that little pipe area, you'll find the 5th red present. Come on, come on, let up. So if you kept watching through, I threw away the blue balls, I didn't know I needed, but when I got to this point, you see these like tree looking things? You can actually throw a ball, the blue ball in it, and there's extra confetti that you can get. So now I'm missing two, so I basically backtracked all the way and collected those blue balls, brought it over, threw them in the eye. So make sure you remember to do that for those extra confetti. It's kind of hidden. If you didn't do that, then you wouldn't be able to unlock those confettis. So after talking to the guy that teaches you how to decorate your character and stuff, you'll come over to this area where you'll see a seesaw with some squirrels. It's going to launch you up to this tree, and that is your last red present for this level.
Everything in every computer. Oh no! Come on in and see. Oh no way! Oh, I'm in and see. I'm in and call to cheese.
Ah, it's Iota, our messenger. And I see you're still with us, out there, peering in, prodding buttons. Now, about this message delivery business. That hole up there is impossibly high. The trees in the orchard ahead can help you, but first, you must help them. Clear out the scraps. Bring back light and colour. Bring back music. This orchard needs a good party. Make it a wassailing to remember. Now get up there.
So shortly after you complete this chapter, it'll tell you to progress forward to go to the next chapter. Before we do that, we actually just unlock the camera, which is useful in collecting the ghost pictures. So the ghost things are these white shadowy things scattered across the map. They're usually in the background. You have to take a picture of it, and then that will unlock the I think it's called paper plan or plan something, whatever it's called, or craft plan, I don't know, something like that, but we'll just call it ghost pictures. Collecting those will earn you part of the 100% that is needed for each chapter. And this is really easy to miss because, you know, you finish the chapter, you just go to the next chapter. Oh, it's called papercraft. So it's a really key thing if you don't want to waste time replaying the level to make sure you go back and collect these four ghost pictures. So I actually shine my light at the one at the end right here. I actually didn't know you had to take a picture of it because, you know, I didn't read instructions. So I went all the way back and I figured out, okay, I actually have to take pictures of them. So if you look at the time description below, it'll tell you exactly where to get all four of them. So I'll talk about that when we get to that part. So the first picture that we have to take is all the way back at the basketball net, and it's right behind the first hoop that we actually sink the squirrel into, and he's actually sitting right at the top of the tree right there. The second picture is also in the basketball net area. It's where we go up this jumpy ramp thing. And I took a picture. I tried taking a picture from the ground, but then it didn't really capture him. So I actually moved back, went up the ramp to take a better picture. So once you take the picture, if it's a white shadowy thing, then that means you didn't capture it properly. Once you take the picture, you're supposed to see the actual color of whatever you're taking a picture of. So, you know, once I get up this thing, I'm gonna try again. Point my camera at it, try to focus. And then once I snap the picture, you're gonna see, okay, you know what? It's not a white shadow anymore. It's actually a picture of something in the background. So that means, okay, I captured it, keep the photo, and then we can move on. The third ghost picture is actually in the theater area. If you go over here with the orange or goldish square, it's actually at the top. This one is really not that hard to miss because it's relatively, it stands out pretty well. And then the last one, if you listen to the commentary all the way through, it's that giraffe looking guy that we missed that is also in the same area behind the leaves and bushes right here. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already, and stay tuned for the next episode. Bye everyone!